I'm Emil from Less EMF. This short video is about the tri-field meter and frequency weighting. Most electrical systems today carry a mixture of signals. In addition to the primary 50 or 60 Hz power signal, there may be higher frequencies present as well. How a Gauss meter evaluates these harmonics and higher frequencies determines the readout that you will see.
This graph represents the typical frequencies present on the wiring of a home. The height of each peak shows the strength of the signal at each frequency. There is a large peak at 60 Hz. Notice that there are many smaller peaks at higher frequencies. This is known as dirty electricity, as it is not a clean 60 Hz signal. Some meters will look at this information and only report the strength of the 60 Hz signal. Other meters will sum the strength of all the frequencies present. This obviously would yield a higher readout, as it includes more than just the 60 Hz signal. And still other meters will count the higher frequencies with more weight than the lower frequencies. That is, they multiply the field reading by a frequency factor. For example, a 1 milligauss field at 60 Hz would read as 1 milligauss, but a 1 milligauss field at 600 Hz would read as 10 milligauss. And a 1 milligauss field at 1200 Hz would read as 20 milligauss. This type of meter gives the highest readout. Frequency weighting is useful because it gives a better indication of the biological impact of the field. Frequency flat meters are more popular as they give a truer reading of the actual field strength.
Tri-field meters are available as either flat frequency or frequency weighted. Look at the label on the back of the meter to see which one you have. Notice that the frequency weighting applies to both the magnetic and electric field settings. Now, let's compare the readout of a flat frequency versus a frequency weighted meter at various frequencies. This coil is connected to a frequency generator, which can produce any frequency we want. It is also connected to this speaker, which will allow us to hear the exact frequency being produced. As I turn the knob, you will hear the different sounds. At the same time, the electromagnetic field from this coil is exactly at this same frequency. First, we have a pure 60 Hz signal. You can hear the characteristic sound. Notice that both meters read about the same. As we change to higher and higher frequencies, the frequency-weighted meter readout shows a greater reading than the flat response meter. Here we have both types of meters, measuring the same field from an extension cord. In this case, the weighted meter measures much higher than the flat meter. This suggests that there's a significant amount of dirty electricity on this line. So, the same field is read differently by the two types of meters because of the presence of dirty electricity and frequency weighting.
If you have only one type of meter, you cannot tell if your readings are influenced by dirty electricity. You can get around this by using both types of meters side by side or by checking with a dirty electricity meter or spectrum analyzer.
The tri-field meter is not the only meter which is frequency weighted. It is important to know what type of meter you're using and to take into account the possibility that high frequency signals may be present when you're making measurements, as they will impact the value of your readings.